Well, hello everyone, and welcome back to the AMT 125th scale, 1968 Shelby GT500 build. And we're back in the paint booth, and we are going to put the body color on. This is not the color that I wanted. I had to throw away. I bought that brand new probably 2 months ago, but I don't know if it sat on their shelf too long or whatever. That color has metal flake in it. And the metal flake, something happened. I shook it and shook it and shook it. And all it did was splatter. The paint came out and it kind of squirt metal flake and sludge. So I'm guessing that paint can that I purchased was probably sitting on the shelf for quite a while. It's no good. But I have this color here, which is a little bit darker. It matches Ford Royal Blue Pearl. And I've already shot the floor or the underside of the car. I was kind of committed. I unfortunately shot the See, it is a nice color, especially in that fluorescent light. But I shot it, and it just splurted all over this. So I let it set for a little bit, level out, and dry enough to where I gave it a good coat of this. And it actually turned out, I didn't think it was going to be something I'd be able to use. I thought I'd have to do some sanding, but it actually turned out pretty well. For that. That's going to be our body color. So I did that. I set the camera up and resprayed this. Because I was kind of in a bummed out mood. Especially with all the paint fails that I've had lately. But I'm happy with that. That actually looks good. So let's grab our firewall. On the box, their picture, they painted the firewall the body color. So I was going to do the same thing. I'm going to hit it from the back. Just in case it squirts funny. And we are just going to hit it. Not doing the light thin coats. I'm doing it kind of wet. Because when I painted the body of the Brougham, I noticed heavy coats. Spray it. Lay off a little bit and then kind of hit it like that so that it gets full coverage and then it evens out looking really nice. That's our firewall.
Like so.
All these parts are kind of going on with the sharing the foam with the USS Iowa parts. Our rear lower panel. Got it set up a little bit. You know, it was probably for the best. That other color was a little bit lighter, but I do like this blue. To pull it out of the light, it's a little darker, but it's going to be one of those, in different lights, it's going to be a different color.
That's where our bumper and everything's going to attach those big rectangular parts. The bumper glues in those.
Alright, what's next? The hood. Let's do the underside first. I'm not too worried about where I got it held here because that's going to be a semi-gloss black.
for the spring. Printed as I move the camera. There you go, make you nauseous. I 3D printed a little simple holder to hold the body on. That's good. Thank you. transmission out of the body here. It's gonna look cool with them white GT stripes on it. That
lower floor turn it. Boy, that looks beautiful. I love it.
Just goes to show you that sometimes when things go wrong, it can, it might end up working for the best. Like I said, it's a little bit darker shade than I wanted, but I kind of like it. The other color did match the factory color better, but no big deal. Well, I'm going to let them all settle, and I'm happy with that. I'd like to thank everybody for watching. We'll see you guys next time.